Today is our 74th Independence Day. It is 73 years since we have become independent. We may have our political differences in ideology, but today is a day when we are united. We have a common dream to make India a superpower. It has taken 73 years and the dream is not yet finished. Maybe in the next 2 decades we will reach there and India will be one of the most powerful nations in the world. I hope so, and I'm sure many of you watching this will be there. Jai Hind. Success of Robinhood app and Zerodha in America and India respectively has started a sudden interest in the low-cost brokerage in India. A company called Upstox started operating a year or two back. Basically, these companies are low brokerage companies or practically zero brokerage companies. They make wafer-thin margins and try to survive. Paytm has been in deep trouble for a long time. Welcome back to Be Rich. Like I said, Paytm was in deep trouble. It started as a wallet and a payment gateway. Google, Facebook through WhatsApp, and PhonePe through Walmart have cornered the majority of the market, leaving Paytm grasping for any market share. Nobody is keeping money in Paytm these days. Paytm is struggling to retain users and is bleeding. It has now tried as a gateway to invest into mutual funds without much success. Paytm has been trying new areas, and one of the areas which I identified since 2018 has been trying to set up a stockbroking firm. In recent times, it has got a license from SEBI. Now, it wants to compete with Upstox and Zerodha to target new users. The market that Paytm, Zerodha and Upstox are targeting are novice retail investors who during the period of lockdown have opened 3 lakh accounts and are trading. Most of these customers have no clue what they are doing, and since they are first-time users, are tempted by a clickbait and get into this. They pour in large sums of money, trade in derivatives and lose money. It is my opinion that these companies should be tightly monitored by SEBI. There have been days when some of these companies have not been able to operate and orders have not gone through to create panic. Today, there are only 2 types of brokers, a full service broker who is attached to a bank, or a discount brokerage which does with nil brokerage. Full service brokers are under tremendous pressures. Very few of them are surviving, and they are facing relentless pressure as Zerodha and Upstox grab more and more of the customer. Broking is not such an easy industry. Will require some guidance to this. Will require that the broking is not an easy industry to penetrate. If retail losers lose money, they will never come back to the market. In the name of protecting the young retail investor, SEBI has made it impossible for most intermediaries to make money. Thus, what happens is, customers don't want to pay brokerage. And because the margins are wafer thin, most brokerage companies have no qualified person who can explain the products or teach these guys what is equity or how to invest properly. Most of the people who picked up are as relation managers or novices. In case of Zerodha and Upstox, what happens is these brokers fund TV channels in which so-called experts keep on doling out trading advice. Gullible investors feel that advice can be implemented on Zerodha and Upstox and lose a lot of money. Of course, I understand buyers beware. But SEBI, in my opinion, has gone overboard in the aim to protect the retail investor, and finally has ended up in such a situation that nobody who is an expert in investments wants to be an intermediary, and therefore the retail investor is a big loser. I am sure Paytm's venture will also end in a bad way. Thank you for watching Be Rich. If you like this video, hit the like button, press the subscriber button, and turn on the bell notification. If you use Kindle, if you press the link below, you will get a Kindle version of my books. If you want a hard copy, send a message to the WhatsApp number given below. At the very end, if you want to speak to me, send a mail to brichenglish@gmail.com. I have one request to make. It's not enough if you subscribe to my channel and see my content. If you feel this content is good, please share it in WhatsApp to your friends and relatives. Make sure they also subscribe to this channel. To provide you content, I need to build a research team and hire more people. Having more subscribers will help. Thank you for supporting BeRich.